is the feast of St. Agnes, Virgin and Martyr of Rome. The epistle is taken from the Book of Ecclesiasticus. O Lord, my King, I give thee thanks. O God, my Deliverer, I praise thee. I extol thy name for all the succour and protection thou hast given me, saving my life from deadly peril, when calumny lay in wait, and lying tongues assailed me. In full sight of all that stood by, thou didst come to my rescue. Roaring lions stood ready to devour me, and thou in that great mercy, that renowned mercy of thine, didst deliver me. I was in the hands of my mortal enemies, shut in on every side by misfortune. There were stifling flames all round me, and I stood in the heart of the fire uninjured. I looked down into the deep womb of the grave, when foul lips brought accusations, and a cruel king gave unjust sentence. While life lasts, this heart shall praise the Lord. If men will but wait for thee patiently, thou dost deliver them. Dost rescue them, O Lord our God, from the power of the heathen. And the gospel today is a continuation of that according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus told his disciples this parable. The kingdom of heaven will be like 10 virgins who went to bring the bridegroom and his bride home, taking their lamps with them. 5 of these were foolish and 5 were wise. The 5 foolish, when they took their lamps, did not provide themselves with oil, but those who were wise took oil in the vessels they carried, as well as the lamps. The bridegroom was long in coming, so that they all grew drowsy and fell asleep. And at midnight the cry was raised, "Behold, the bridegroom is on his way. Go out to meet him." Thereupon all these virgins awoke and fell to trimming their lamps. And now the foolish one said to the wise, "Share your oil with us. Our lamps are burning low." But the wise ones answered, "How if there is not enough for us and for you? Better that you should find your way to the merchants and buy for yourselves." And so, while they were away buying it, the bridegroom came. Those who stood ready escorted him to the wedding, and the door was shut. Afterwards, those other virgins came with a cry, "Lord, Lord, open to us." And he answered, "Believe me, I do not recognize you. Be on the watch then, the day of it and the hour of it are unknown to you." And the proper gospel for today, being the third Sunday after Epiphany, is a continuation also of that of St. Matthew. At this time a great multitude followed Jesus when he had come down from the mountain, and now a leper came and knelt before him and said, "Lord, if it be thy will, thou hast power to make me clean." Jesus stretched out his hand and touched him and said, "It is my will, be thou made clean." Whereupon his leprosy was immediately cleansed. Then Jesus said, "Be sure thou dost not tell any man of it. Rather go and show thyself to the priest and offer the gift which Moses ordained to make the truth known to them." As he entered Capernaum, a centurion came to him asking for his aid. "Lord," he said, "I have a servant lying sick at my house, cruelly tormented with a palsy." Jesus said to him, "I will come and heal him." But the centurion answered, "Lord, I am not worthy to receive thee under my roof. My servant will be healed if thou wilt only speak a word of command. I too know what it is to obey authority. I have soldiers under me, and I say, 'Go,' to one man, and he goes. Come to another, and he comes. Or, 'Do this,' to my servant, and he does it." When he heard this, Jesus said to his followers in amazement, "Believe me, I have not found faith like this, even in Israel. And this I tell you, that there are many who will come from the east and from the west, and will take their places in the kingdom of God with Abraham and Isaac and Jacob, while that kingdom's own sons will be cast into the darkness without, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth." And to the centurion Jesus said, "Go then, let it be done to thee as thy faith foretold." And at that hour his servant was healed. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Amen. Charisma, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass on this, the feast of St. Agnes. St. Agnes of Rome. Do excuse me. I shall obviously try and keep this brief. Yes, St. Agnes of Rome, one of the great, greatly adored Virgin Martyrs of the Church, who bore witness to Christ with her death in martyrdom under the persecution of the Ecclesian toward the end of the 3rd century AD. At the tender age of 13, she had been spotted by Symphoronius, the governor's son in Rome, who desired her. She, though, refused his approaches, saying that she was betrothed to none other than her God and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Symphoronius, of course, was not happy with this and thus denounced her to his father, the governor, and so she was arrested. They tried then to pluck her virginity by confining her to a brothel. However, she was accompanied by an angel, and such a bright light shone around her that anybody who tried to approach her was blinded. Eventually, they gave up, and she was beheaded. She is buried in the church that bears her name in Rome, and her name, of course, has a place in the canon of the Mass. Today, of course, too, is the third Sunday after Epiphany, where we are still, as it were, ourselves concerned with the thoughts of marriage. Now, St. Agnes is seen as a type of the Church, of course, herself having been betrothed to Christ, in much the same way that we, of course, as the Church, Christ is our bridegroom. And ought we then, in our lives ourselves, seek to emulate and to express that sacrificial love, that all-consuming and self-giving love, such as St. Agnes had for Christ, such as Christ has for his Church, such as Christ has for each and every one of us individually, and thus ought we to return to him and God. We ought, my brothers and sisters, as usual, always to ask ourselves, how much do I love God? Do I love him that much that he is constantly at the forefront of my thoughts? Is he the first thing I think of when I wake? Is he the last thing I think of when I sleep? Does he occupy my mind all throughout the day? And that, my brothers and sisters, indeed may seem a strange proposition to some, and yet the summary of the Lord tells us there are no two commandments greater than these, and the first is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, and with all your strength. If we fail in that first commandment, my brothers and sisters, we cannot succeed in the second part, to truly love our neighbour, let alone ourselves. For if we truly would love ourselves, if we truly desire for ourselves the fulfilment of our purpose and meaning in life, we can only find it in God. We can only find it in him who made us, in him who purposed us into being, in him who desires us to be with him, both now and forever. We, my brothers and sisters, are, of course, like to be that centurion we hear of in the commemorative gospel today. That we should have such faith as that centurion that impressed even our Saviour. It is for that reason that Holy Mother Church gives us his words to speak at the invitation to Holy Communion. First, we hear the immortalized words of St. John the Baptist. Ecce omnius Dei, ecce qui tollit peccatum mundi. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. And then we respond, Domine non sum dignus. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldest come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. And then do we receive, and are we not touched, healed, restored, and forgiven, as we receive into ourselves the body, blood, soul, and divinity of Christ, as we receive that new bread of heaven, as we receive that bread of the angels, as we receive that bread of eternal life, as we receive into ourselves the mystery of the incarnation and the miracle of Bethlehem, so that we might become one in him as he becomes one in us. And in so doing, may be ourselves transformed, may within ourselves be reconciled spiritually and materially, to demonstrate and bear witness to the world the reconciliation and the restoration of Creator and created that exists in the perfect unity of Christ, both man and God. We might ask ourselves, my brothers and sisters, are we like a contemporary Agnes? Are we all pure, or seeking or striving to purity? Are we so in love with God that we would be prepared to lose our lives for his sake? These are questions we often ask ourselves on these feasts of the martyrs, and with a thought too for those of our brethren around the world who are indeed facing the prospect of death for the sake of Christ. As we reflect many times, it is all too easy for us to feel somewhat not to feel any pressure. Indeed, this, of course, my brothers and sisters, such is the apostasy in the church today that most Christians in the West are not aware, and not aware of the level of persecution inflicted upon Christ's body, the church, are ignorant of the suffering of our brothers and sisters in the faith elsewhere in the world, and themselves, having fallen into apostasy, have fallen into apathy. And because they don't perceive any physical threat to themselves, they fail to see the persecution that truly exists in the world around us today, not just in the Middle East and in Africa and parts of Asia, but here in the West, where the voice of the church, the voice of objective truth, is continually being ignored and shouted down. And yes, my brothers and sisters, though we are not all of us blessed to be orators, we're not all of us blessed to be preachers, yet we are all of us charged to proclaim the gospel. And we proclaim the gospel of love by living in love, but remembering, not as the apostates do, thinking that love means niceness, but remember true love, the nature of that love about which we speak of concerning the Godhead, is sacrificial love. If we would live our lives demonstrably, sacrificially for God and for each other, then the world might yet recognize us, as our Lord himself said, and then pay heed to us. But all the time, the apostates make us look like hypocrites. The world will not listen to us. Which is why it's ever more important that we, who are the faithful remnant of the church, must become bolder, must become braver, must become more demonstrable witnesses to the truth of the faith in the love of God made manifest in Christ, and live sacrificially, and love sacrificially. Let us, my brothers and sisters, so strive to emulate the example of St. Agnes and of all the saints, that we, though we are sinners, might yet in this, the body of Christ, a school for saints, might yet realize for ourselves and for others the presence still of Emmanuel, God with us, and the fullness of our redemption in him, who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, facom caeli et terrae visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum filium Deum unigenitum, et ex patri in altum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deum lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo verum, genito non factum consustantianem patri, eque omnia factus sunt. Qui propter nos homines et propter nostrum salutem, descendi de caelis, et incarnatus est de Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis sub Pontio Pilatu passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit est in die secundum Scripturas, et descendit in caelum sedet extra patris, et itero venturus est cum gloria judicare vivos et mortuos, cuius veni non erit finis, et in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum et vivificantem, qui ex patri procedit, qui cum Patria et Filius semel adoratorum glorificatum, qui locutus est per prophetas, et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confiti unum baptismo in remissionem peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vita venturi saeculi. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spiritu tuo. Oremus. Afferentur regi virgines post eam, proximius afferentur tibi laetitia et exultatione, adducentur in templum regi Domine. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo sursum corda, habemus ad Dominum, gratias agamus Domino Deo nostro, dignum et justum est, vere dignum et justum est, equam salutare nostri sempre dubique, gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater omnipotens et eterne Deus, qui cum unigenito Filio tuo Spiritus Sancto, unus est Deus, unus est Dominus, non in unius singularitate in persona, sed in unite, sed in unius trinitate in substantia. Quale in de tua gloria revelante te credimus, hoc de Filio tuo, hoc de Spirito Santo, sine differentia discretioni sensimus. Ut in confessione vera est abitinae quae deitatis, et in personis proprietas, et in essentia unitas, et in maestate doletur qualitas. Quam laudat angeli atque angeli cherubim quoque et serfim, qui non cessant clamare quotidie una voce dicente: Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus. Dominus Deus Sabaoth, pleni sum caeli et terra gloria tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis. Magna Secula Seculorum. Amen. Arrens, recepti salutaribus maliti divinis dulciani formati, ademus dice. Padre noster qui es in cieli, sanctificet tu nom tuum, ad veniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sic da nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris. Et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos ad malo. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum. Et cum spirito tuo. Ecce omnius ei, ecce qui tollit peccatum mundi. Domine, non sum dignus, ut intressa tectum meam, sed tantum dic verbo. Domine, non sum dignus, ut intressa tectum meam, sed tantum dic verbo et sed labitur anima meam. Domine, non sum dignus, ut intressa tectum meam, sed tantum de fermo, et sed abitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen. Quae prudentes virgines acceperunt oleum in vasi suis cum labaribus, medio autem nocte clamo vactus est, et responsus venit, exite oviam Christo Domino. Dominus obiscum, et cum spirito tuo, ordem. perfecti cibo potuque celesti Deus nas te supplices es oratus, ut in cuius hecum emulatione pecebimus, eus muniamur et pecibus. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, vitecum vivida regna ad humanitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Ordinus. Quas tantis Domini lascidis ultimis edis, quaesmus, ut effetibus nostre orum veraciter ad tali dignenis. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum Filium Tuum, vitecum vivida regna ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Ite missa est, Deo gratia. Nomen Domini benedictum ex oblongo disque in saecula, aut orum nostrum in nomine Domini qui feci caelum et terram, benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Dominus vobiscum et in spirito tuo. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum. Gloria Tibi Domine. In illo tempore condescendisit Iesus de monte, secute sunt eum turbe multe, ed ecce leprosus veniens adoravat eum dicens, Domine, si vis, potes me mundare. Ed extendens Iesus manium, te dicit eum dicens, Volo, mundare. Et confesti mundater est lepreus. Et ei dile Iesus, Vide, nemini diseris, sed vade, ostende te sacerdoci, et offer munus quod precepit Moses in testimonium minis. Cum autem introvisit Capernaum, aucesit ad eum centurio, rogans eum et dicens, Domine, pue meus iacet in domo paraliticus, et male toquetur. Et eit ili Iesus, Ego veniam et curavo eum. Et respondens centurio et, Domine, non sum dignus ut intre sub tectum meam, sed tantum dit verbo, et senabitur puer meus. Damet ego homus sum sub potestate constitutus habens sub me milites, et dico huic, Vade et vadit, et alii veni et venit, et servo meo fac hoc et facit. Audiens autem Iesus miratus est, et sequentibus edicit, Amen dico vobis, non in veni tantam fidem in Israel. Dico autem vobis, quod multi ab oriente et occidente venient, et recumbent cum Abraham et Isaac et Jacob in regno celorum, fili autem regii centur in tenebras exteriores, ibi eri fletus est trigo densium. Et dixit Iesus centurioni, Vade, et sicut credidisti fiat tibi. Et senatus est pue in illa horra. Deo gratia. God save Elizabeth our Queen, and graciously hear us when we call upon thee. Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray for thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, upon whom thy mercy has laid the government of this kingdom. May she be given still greater measure of every virtue, Fast worthily adorned, may she turn aside from all wickedness. May she overcome her enemies and with her consort and the royal family. May she come at last in grace to thee, the way, the truth, and the life. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Hail the Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy. Hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this vale of tears. Turn, then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy toward us, and after this our exile show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. O God, who art our refuge and our strength, look down in mercy on thy people who cry to thee, and by the intercession of the glorious and blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and St. Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and all thy saints, in mercy and goodness hear our prayers for the conversion of sinners and for the liberty and exaltation of our Holy Mother, the Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Holy Michael, Archangel, defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast down to hell Satan and all wicked spirits who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. May St. Agnes, Virgin and Martyr of Rome, pray for us. May St. Wilfrid of York, pray for us. May St. Catherine of Stenning, pray for us. May St. Louina of Alfriston, pray for us. May St. Richard of Chichester, pray for us. May Our Lady of Walsingham, pray for us. May our holy guardian angels, pray for us. May our heavenly patron saints, pray for us. May Our Lady Queen of Heaven, all the angels and saints, pray for us.